Hello students, in today's class, let us read the story, Who is to Blame? Who is to Blame is a play. What is a play? A play is a story acted out. In play, the performers act and deliver dialogues. This play, Who is to Blame, is adapted from Chinese folktale. Chinese folktale is a collection of tales. These tales mainly focus on China's tradition, culture, and it also emphasizes moral values and the power of wisdom. And this play, Who is to Blame, revolves around 13 characters. They are Chim Chong. He is a young fisherman. Prawn, wood apple, tree, cock, antler, snake, boar, plantain tree, bat, elephant, boulder, old woman, and the chef toad. Now let me start narrating the story. I want you all to imagine the story completely. Yes, let me start. This play takes place in a small village which is on the top of the hill. The village name is Myanmar. So students, imagine a village which is on the top of the hill, and also imagine a river passing through the village, and there we could find young fisherman named Chim Chong sitting on the bank of the river, and he was sharpening his axe on a stone. So the fisherman, young fisherman Chim Chong, he was having an axe on his hand. Suddenly, the prawn which was inside the river was irritated by the sound of the axe. So, it bit the fisherman on his leg. The fisherman cried out in pain, and his axe which was on his hand flew out, and it cut the trunk of the wood apple tree. The cut was very deep. The wood apple tree became very angry and it tried to drop an apple on Chim Chong's head. But the apple was hit on Mr. Cock's head. Mr. Cock yelled at the wood apple tree, telling, "You are stronger and bigger than me. Why do you want to do this to me?" Mr. Cock became very angry, and so it decided to take revenge. It started scratching up a nest of busy ants. It thought that the ants would crawl up the wood apple tree and it would destroy the tree. The ants were disturbed by the cock's scratch, so they decided to attack the cock, but unfortunately they happened to attack a snake which had crossed their way. Oh, suffering from the ant's bite, the snake wriggled and ran towards the forest, and it bit an innocent boar on its leg. Getting an unexpected bite from the snake, the boar cried out in pain. The boar could not bite the snake back, so it started to find some medicinal roots. It ran fast and dug up the roots of a plantain tree. With its full energy, it dug up the roots, but the tree fell down. And the bat, which was sleeping on the plantain tree, was disturbed by the disaster. It started flying blindly, and accidentally it rushed into the ear of an elephant. and the elephant was drinking water from the river. And the bat found itself in a dark, hairy and smelly place. And so it bit the elephant's ear. The elephant cried out in pain and it raised its front legs and it kicked a boulder which was near it. The boulder crashed into the hut and broke one of its walls. On hearing the noise, the terrible sound, an old woman who lived in the hut came out and she became very angry on seeing the broken wall. The old woman asked the boulder to pay for the damage it had caused. The boulder told that it didn't do anything, but because of the elephant it happened, because the elephant had kicked it against the wall. The old woman asked the elephant to pay or to rebuild their house. Still suffering from the pain caused by the bat, the elephant replied that it kicked the boulder because of the bat's terrible bite. On hearing the elephant's reply, the bat replied that because of the plantain tree's unexpected terrible moment, it acted like that. The old woman went to the plantain tree, which was lying on the ground. She asked it to pay for her house. The fully damaged plantain tree said that it had happened because of the boar. And so the old woman went to meet the boar and she asked it to pay for her house. The wounded boar said that everything had happened because of the snake who bit it on its leg. And the old woman became very furious and she rushed towards the snake and lifted the snake by its tail. And she asked the snake to pay for her house. The snake apologized and said that the ants disturbed it, that's why it had bitten the boar. The old woman found the anthill and knocked it and asked the mini beast, that is ants, to come out to have a quarrel. She asked them to pay for her house. The ants replied that they didn't do anything and said even their house was damaged by Mr. Cock. The woman inquired Mr. Cock. The cock replied that the wooden apple tree tried to kill it by hitting it with an apple. On hearing it, the apple tree joined the conversation. It said that it was because of the careless fisherman who cut it with his axe made the wood apple tree to behave like that. The old woman saw the young man and she found that it was her own son, Chim Chong. She asked the son to rebuild their house. Her son accepted to rebuild, but he wanted to catch the little prawn who had started all these disasters. The young fisherman threw the net into the river and caught the prawn and told that it deserved to die. Meanwhile, all the other creatures gathered around the fisherman Chim Chong and the old woman. And Chim Chong called the chef Toad to prepare delicious prawn soup. Chef Toad prepared and tasted the prawn soup. It ate small piece of prawn in the beginning and soon the Chef Toad finished eating all the prawns. The other creatures who came to taste the prawn were disappointed as the soup did not have any prawn at all. And so they chased Chef Toad, who had eaten all the prawn. And that's all, students. The story ends here. It's a very funny story. it, there must be a lesson to learn from every story. Let us see what are the things we could learn from this story. Some of the people may do wrong things to us. It could be intentionally or unintentionally. But we should forgive them, because hate leads to hate, fight leads to fight, and blame leads to blame. So stop blaming and start living your life happily. Spread love, spread kindness. Thank you, students. Have a great day.